Thank you, Marco, for inviting me to this session to share a little bit about Esri, my company. We started it 52 years ago, and today it's advancing GIS technology and geospatial science. We're actually the world leader in mapping and GIS technologies. We have many offices that represent us and support our roughly 350,000 organizational customers. They're cities, they're utilities, they're national agencies, they're in the private sector, they're in the academy. We have about 10 million users, believe it or not, who are actively using our tools almost invisibly in backgrounds, making maps, doing various kinds of analysis. And their work is addressing so many of the challenges that our world is facing today. I would make the assertion that they're creating, in their own way, a more sustainable future. Some of them are working in conservation assessment and planning and management, setting up reserve areas, doing fundamental science between the natural world and the human footprint. Some of them are doing fundamental environmental and natural resource management, looking at the whole world in terms of biodiversity, like the great work going on by the E.O. Wilson Foundation, or science work showing what's happening at the Arctic, or fires, or forest management of various types. They're looking for solutions like renewable energy. Where can we best locate solar collectors or best locate wind farms, et cetera? Our users are creating better cities, more efficient cities, by doing effective regional planning, considering sustainability planning. They're picking optimum locations for transportation. They're looking at issues of equity and social justice. They're really amazing footprints on the planet. Others are working in businesses. They're optimizing businesses, not only in terms of locating them in the best place, but also optimizing things like supply chains and delivery routes of various types. And they're using a variety of data sets from satellite information, like these examples here, looking at the whole planet at one time, to the idea of looking at micro areas, pulling out features from images using AI and machine learning. Lots of interesting challenges here. Esri has, as I mentioned, about 350,000 user organizations, and some of these are just mammoth in scale. But we also have thousands of special relationships in the NGO world where we provide our software for free to NGOs around the world. And their work is similar to the examples that I showed. They're laying down footprints of sustainability, conservation sustainability, humanitarian missions, etc. We also enjoy a rich business partner ecosystem. While we are a several billion-dollar operation, we also drag partner ecosystem of about 28 billion. And these organizations apply our tools in various ways, and they include big ones, but also thousands of small ones. We have a rich startup program for helping startups use our tools to build maps and take the geographic approach in their work. As we know from this conference, our world is being challenged. We are threatening our future, frankly. The combination of uncontrolled human-induced climate change and overpopulation are leading to so many issues, severe drought, not enough food. Well, we know these very well. Collectively, we're going to have to be responsible for a future. And this is a new chapter for human beings. The sort of Anthropocene epic of our world is going to require that we face the reality of the footprints that we're laying down and change. Sustainability is actually possible, it's my strong belief, but we're going to have to see the world as one system, not just from an environmental perspective, but also from an economic perspective and also a social perspective. We can actually use geography as a science and a language to bring these different disciplines together, spatialize them. So geography provides us not only the science, but also the language to organize all of these factors as layers of information, and then look at relationships and patterns. This provides us a framework for not only understanding what's going on, but also action. This geographic approach is a way of thinking and a way of solving problems that's holistic and integrative and multi-participant in nature. It allows everybody to play and see the world not just through money or not just through spreadsheets, but seeing the context as well as what's actually happening. GIS, the technology that I create and our whole organization is built on, enables this geographic approach. Our customers are measuring the world, sometimes with satellites and sometimes with field measurements. They are visualizing and making maps, billions of maps every day. They're doing analytics, predicting the future. They're doing design work. They're doing decision making. And ultimately, they take geographic thinking right into the field with human action. This technology is advancing rapidly. We call it ArcGIS. That's our brand name. But it's integrating and leveraging many other technologies like cloud computing and remote sensing AI and machine learning. It's all coming together into this platform. It's creating what I like to call geospatial infrastructure. In other words, our individual players, these 10 million or so players with their desktops or their servers or their cloud computing or their apps, interconnecting their systems using web services. And this is creating a new generation, a new type of GIS, geospatial infrastructure, which weaves together individual organizations' work into a dial tone of geographic reality, a kind of digital twin. And this is expanding rapidly. The interconnection of our various customers' information and making it available freely by sharing and using each other's data has resulted in what I would describe as a new kind of information system, a nervous system for sustainability. Actually, there are billions of maps being made on this platform right now, and it is open, and it's reaching the world with a new kind of visualization of what's going on. It's enabling powerful applications, and some of them are for the high-end user doing desktop analytics or modeling, but many of them are for field people using massive deployments on devices like Apple's device or Android devices. And then the web environment is allowing pervasive access with literally millions and millions of views of information every minute. This is empowering the world to see the world differently and also organize the world differently. And it's not simply simple apps. It's also deeply embedded with other kinds of analytics. So those of you who are interested in data science, this framework allows us to do predictive modeling, to see space and time together, to access big data reservoirs, to be able to integrate imagery in the cloud and do massive computing raster modeling of various types. And in the last decade, the emergence of AI and machine learning, what we call GeoAI, is emerging as a powerful force. All of this information, all of this infrastructure is now available as location services or open data and rich developer experiences to be able to support the creation of solutions. And this is what this conference is about. I'm simply sharing that this powerful framework, this powerful infrastructure is going to change the world. And I invite you to be my partners in making that so. The living atlas of information with literally millions of data sets now available openly for developers is going to support a whole new generation of developers. So let me conclude with a couple of final thoughts. You and I are here because our world is being challenged on many fronts, and we are going to have to be collectively responsible for its future. This geographic approach, bringing everything together, and the infrastructure that's emerging can provide us rich science and very practical means to be able to come up with creative solutions, to be able to think and operate more effectively. But it isn't going to be enough. And when Marcos asked me to talk here, it really caused me to realize that creating a sustainable future is going to require not just people like you, but you. And the work that you're going to be doing the rest of your career is going to be essential. Creating effective solutions and promoting this idea of integrated thinking, problem solving, holistic approaches, collaboration, and then, of course, just the spirit of motivation that brought this conference together, going all in and acting with urgency. One of my great friends is E.L. Wilson. He recently published these thoughts. "We only have a short time," he said, "and we are in a kind of race to save our living environment, and of course that really means us as well." So I invite all of you to connect with me. I'm absolutely interested in supporting you in your work in building out this geospatial nervous system for our planet and creating a sustainable future. Thank you very much.